Hi, my name is Victor Bart and welcome to Retro Machines. And I'm already tripping over some boxes because my studio is way too full. And I picked up this Switch this week and I got those Switches donated to me. And my server rack is pretty full. So, what's my plan? I don't know. Maybe I need a second rack. Yeah, I think it's time to put a second server rack in my way too small studio. That sounds as an excellent plan with no complications. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. If you want your circuit board design realized and printed, you should check out PCBWay. Starting prices as low as $5 for a one or two layer design with worldwide shipping. Place your order now, links in the description. So my plan for today is to take out some items from my studio, bring it to my workshop. In my workshop I have a candidate for an extra rack in my studio, and I need to use my angle grinder on that rack to make it a little bit better. So let's get started. This Super Micro server can go to my storage. I'm maybe gonna use it as the file server for my retro LAN party setup. Also, let's get rid of this Dell 2400. It's just a terrible machine and really dirty. Look what I just found. A trunking cable with four UTP cables, which will be perfect to make some test runs between the switches before I go with fiber trunks. I'm in my workshop and I have this 22U rack out of a flight case. My brother gave it to me, and I think this is a perfect candidate to put in my YouTube studio as a rack for all the extra network equipment. There's a logo here, ALC Systems. We have a lot of case nuts already here, and even a little rail in the rear, but not a full rail. But there is some extra material here that I want to remove, and this bar will be gone. So let's start with that and make some sparks. Much better without all the extra metal, but I have now some blank pieces and I don't have blue paint and all the shops are still closed, and it's really hard to match colors if you order on the internet. So I'm gonna use black spray paint for now just to cover it up, and maybe later someday I will just repaint the whole rack. So the paint is drying now, so let's talk about all the servers I bought. And the stack is less big because, yeah, I scrapped some. All the Celeron D's are gone. So I kept the two dual Pentium 3's with the Intel motherboards, the other two dual Pentium 3's, of course the Sun machines, and these are empty cases, but I still need to find the right key to open them because I need to get the hard drives out and then see what I'm gonna do with them. But I probably will keep the cases because they match perfectly with this one. And I also took apart the two white boxes, but I will keep the boxes, but the hardware was completely trash, so that was not interesting. And here we have the 1U boxes where all the Celeron D's were in. To be honest, not sure what I'm gonna do with them. I probably gonna just reuse the fans and the power supplies, stuff like that, and maybe keep them for a while if I have something for it, I can build it in, and otherwise not sure yet. But from the motherboards, I saved this one and P5P800S. I still need to test it out, but I probably gonna sell it on a LAN party for cheap for someone that wants to do something with it. But all the Celerondis were on really stupid server motherboards. And probably next week I'm gonna make a video trying out the 4 Pentium 3 systems. I hope they really work, otherwise I need to repair them. And let me show you a secret which I am a little bit scared to tell you. Because, yeah, I scrap sometimes some parts. So let me give you a tour of Victor's scrapping and waste department. Here we have just metal. This box is full of PCBs. And this is like super crappy hardware or broken parts or stuff like that. And these were the motherboards from the Celeron D's. And yeah, it's just an interesting hardware. A lot of copper cables and network cables and other cables and copper and aluminium and connectors and all kinds of stuff. So the rack is done and it even has RGB. That's an easy fit. A Volvo V70 is perfect to move server racks. Here is the reason why I need more rack space in my room. Because I have here 28 U of HP switches. And I'm gonna build a retro LAN party setup. And for the LAN party I will use the HP 5308 XLs. And the 5304 XLs. So I need a place in my room to store them and to configure them. And the best thing to do that is to put them in a rack. My Sun rack doesn't use case nuts but threaded holes. But on this one we have case nuts. So let's remove the case nuts so we can reposition them for the switches. I'm probably gonna hate case nuts after this installation. I don't really miss them on my rack when installing SunCare, but some HP and Supermicrocare won't fit in there, so it's a debate what which is better. Case nuts are the most compatible and the rounded holes are the most easy. And of course I hurt my finger while removing them. This is really nice. It came with 38 case nuts. So I have enough for my 4 switches in this rack. Let's install the switches in the rack. But they are pretty heavy. So I need to support them and hold them in place. And figure out the case nuts. So I have a pretty good idea. Which you normally can't do if you have a server rack. I will just put it on its side. And now I can just put the switches in, position them, and work on them without holding them. Brilliant. Super heavy now. Let's see if I can lift it. I think it's 12 kilos per switch plus the weight of the rack. That's a lot of network ports. I'm super happy how this turned out. It looks just amazing. But right now all the modules are all over the place and a little bit of a mess. Because this is how I bought or cut the switches in the exact configuration. And I was thinking maybe it's interesting to show you how they were used. So these four switches are all HP5308XLs, and they use the XL modules, and you have 8 modules per switch. So the two switches on top came from a big German industrial company, and they are fully gigabit and also with SFP ports here. So this is the configuration how they were used in a data center. This switch I bought on eBay. So this switch here is fully populated with 4 gigabit ports on top, and the 724 port blades are 10 100 Mbit. So there are two possibilities with this switch, because I bought it on eBay. The first possibility is that the seller just dumped all the 10 100 blades in it and tried to sell it. Maybe. Or what also is a possibility, that this was on the client side with a lot of computers on it and with a 4 gigabit trunk to the rest of the network. But probably it's the first one, that the seller just want to get rid of the 10 100 blades. But I want to make a retro LAN party, so the 10 100 blades were a priority for me. So that's why I bought this one, just to get all the ports. And this one I bought on a local eBay marketplace from some guys that made LAN parties. And I think these were the leftover blades, because they still have a 5308 with fully gigabit. And this one is just with 10 100 blades. Also, this is a 10 100 blade, but this is the power over Ethernet blade. So I can use the HP access points for this system with power over Ethernet. And this is just a Wi-Fi B and G standard. And I have 3 access points that was in the complete package. So for the retro LAN party, I have a normal BG network. So if you want to bring your old Pentium 3 or Pentium 4 laptop, we also will provide you Wi-Fi. To get the Wi-Fi working, you need a module, and that is this module. This is a Wi-Fi module. So without a Wi-Fi module, you can't use the access points. In this configuration, you also cannot use the power over Ethernet. They have huge power supplies, but to use the power over Ethernet, you need a rack mount 1U power supply with very heavy cables that goes from the back to the front to this connector. That is so impractical. But I bought this switch with the power supply, the cables and the access points for 50 euros. So it's a complete package, and the nice thing is I almost have now all the modules there are for this system. I only don't have the 12FX 100 megabit fiber port option, but that's also the least interesting blade. And I don't have the 10 gigabit blades, because they are super hard to find or super expensive. So I'm gonna search for them on eBay if I can get them cheap. But for now, we're gonna just use 4 gigabyte trunks between the switches, and it will be probably more than enough with 10 100 clients, and then also a VLAN for modern machine for streaming. And this will be a super powerful network. So the fifth switch for the LAN is only a 4 base chassis, and this is the 5304XL, and I bought this on eBay. And this is a configuration that could be used by a company with 3 24 port 10 100s and 1 gigabit blade, and also with 2 SFP ports. So yeah, I now have 5 switches for the LAN party, and there are 2 more on the way. Yeah, I know, that's an overkill. But in the switches that are on the way, we have the 4 port SFP blades 4 times, and also 3 10 100s and 1 full gigabit blade. So the reason why I also bought the 6th and the 7th switch, because then we have some spares, because all the power supplies can be swapped around, and three of the big ones has dual power supplies, the rest have all singles. It's good to have some spares for the LAN party, because it's old equipment from around 2005, so things can break. The switches like these are just like Legos. I can just take out blades, put them in something else, configure my own switches how I want them, where I need which port. So it's super flexible, this system. And it's pretty cheap on eBay right now if you buy complete switches, because the blades itself are sometimes crazy expensive. In the next video about the switches, I will do the basic configuration. I will show you the blades. There's even a blade with a real CPU socketed and memory. So we're gonna explore which CPU it is. And I will explain how I gonna connect them all. I'm still waiting on a package from a sponsor for all the cabling between the switches. My Sun rack is 38U. This rack is 22U. That makes 60U of rack space, and it's almost full. I think I have an overkill. But don't worry, I don't power it all day long. I only will power this one up when I configure it, and then I turn it off, so it doesn't use that much power. So the day that I have two racks in my studio finally came, and my studio is super tiny, so yeah, I now have less room in my studio, but I like it. If you like to support me, you can support me monthly on Patreon, and for $1 a month you can join my Discord server, where I show all kinds of pictures of this setup the whole time, and you can use my Amazon affiliated links. Thanks for watching.